This is not a fever dream. I know this looks like the video from The Ring where you watch it and then 7 days later someone crawls through your fucking screen and kills you. This is none of that. This is an animated short film called Thievin' from a studio called Thilakanathan Studios. Undoubtedly, the first thing you notice from the short clip I played you is that the animation is exquisite and rivals that of Pixar's work. But that's not what makes Thievin' a masterpiece, so please snuggle on up, get in your favorite butt plug, and join me as we journey through the exciting world of Thievin'. Did you blink? Because if you did, you may have missed a very important piece of Thievin' lore. I'll go ahead and rewind the shot and slow it down for you. As the director pans the camera around the house, you'll notice a dragon flies into frame very briefly, very reminiscent of the scene from Pokemon Episode 1 where Ash looks up and sees a mysterious Pokemon many fans speculate was a Ho-Oh. Well, in this case, Thievin' fans and enthusiasts speculate that this was no dragon, this was a Ho-Oh, and thus Thievin' made a wish to be part of the world's best animation, and goddammit, that shit came true. This right here is one thing I've always appreciated about Thievin'. The characters are very over-animated, and they're very dramatic, but in the right amount of flavor to it, you know, just the right amount of zing. So when Mia's giving Thievin' the bad news about having to go, she has her mouth wide open like she's gasping for air and suffocating her, like trying to catch goldfish in her mouth as she tosses him in the air. No, Thievin', have to go. The next day, Mia throws on her backpack and gets ready for the 20-day journey. She's whispering secrets to the house, hoping Thievin' doesn't destroy it, and then she arms the ADT alarm system. Mia and Thievin' then take a casual stroll over to the marketplace to look for some condoms and breadsticks. Oh look, it's my favorite shirt. I fucking love this shot right here. That's no doubt like the director of this, and he plugs his merch in the actual Thievin' universe. That is absolutely outstanding work right there. So in the spirit of this brave man, I'll do something similar. Go check me out at twitch.tv/moistcritical. I'll go ahead and link that shit in the comments section. Would love to see you there. You got a small dick if you're not there. After an exciting adventure at the marketplace, me and Thievin' go to the lake to cool down and unwind with the local First Baptist competitive esports marching band, and they all jump into the lake and disappear like it's a fucking Super Mario 64 level. Thievin' T-poses and also hits the YMCA dance on the back of a dragon he found while leaving the lake. This scene's not too dissimilar from the Harry Potter scene with Harry on the back of Buckbeak. I honestly think J.K. Rowling may have stolen from Thievin', so I'm actually a bit excited now that this has been exposed to see J.K. Rowling defend this blatant plagiarism. I'm sure she'll do the classic J.K. Rowling approach and just retroactively change some of her lore to include Thievin' in the universe, like, you know, just a vague tweet. Oh, I never said Thievin' wasn't part of the Harry Potter universe. In fact, I never actually said Harry Potter was the main character. In fact, Thievin' was the main wizard the whole time. It was Thievin' Potter, you fucking idiots. Thievin' and Mia ride the origami bird for a long time before transcending past heaven, high-fiving God on their way to the next plane of existence. Before going on her 20-day-long journey, Mia honors Thievin's birthday by giving him the gift he's always wanted, a giant kidney stone that she had passed just days before. Mia leaves Thievin' behind as she begins her new life as a pirate aboard the Black Pearl. fucking scene makes me tear up every time I see this. I've seen this movie upwards of 20 times by now, and that scene still always gets to me, right to my very core. This is about the halfway point of the movie here, so we'll take a break so you can wipe the tears from your eyes, wipe your asshole in case you've been leaking a little bit, and just get ready for the next act of Thieving, because this is where it really takes off into this crescendo of madness, adventure, testosterone, feelings, lactation. All of these feelings, emotions, and enzymes come together and create the Thieving experience. You don't want to miss it, so yeah, let's just fucking get right back into it. Mia and her crew see the ferocious dragon approach and desperately try to escape, but unfortunately the water for which they once sailed has been transmuted into oil and mud. Steven is understandably horrified as the dragon has just incinerated his beloved Mia and her entire crew. Steven's face says it all. He is disturbed and scarred after witnessing this dragon literally bend over Mia and buttfuck her mouth. Genuinely just dropped his trousers and Cleveland steamered Mia right aboard that pirate ship, and Steven was in the front row watching. This is like some Batman shit when Bruce Wayne watched his parents get shot, but this is amplified by 10 times, and Thieving is about to become DC's most heroic hero after witnessing this tragedy. The dynamite aboard Mia's ship that she intended to sell to the highest bidder is all ignited at once by the dragon's flames, and the ship bursts. Thieving can only look on in sadness as the ship goes out in a blazing inferno and is slowly swallowed by the ocean. Thieving, now homeless after Mia's death, takes refuge among a camp of pedophiles who welcome him with open arms. After leaving Tutorial Island and venturing through Lumbridge, Thieving is ambushed by a group of goblins that intend to take his lunch money and his virginity. Yes, you saw that correctly. Thieving is actually using a Rikishi stink face, shoving his entire asshole on the face of the goblin. That is the ultimate fighting technique, executed flawlessly by the master martial artist Thieving. Yet again, science wins. Thieving sadly eats a watermelon for nearly 2 minutes of screen time. It turns out Thieving is a pedophile magnet as he swims out into the ocean and is greeted by a legendary sea monster pedophile. Moments before Thieven was devoured, the papier-mâché dragons made their way back and saved him in the world's slowest getaway. This shit is like straight out of Homer's The Odyssey. In fact, this puts that to shame, if I'm being honest. Thieven prepares for the final boss battle to avenge his Mia. Thieven wasn't prepared for the final boss battle. Mia turns over in her grave out of embarrassment because Thieven's failure just spit on her fucking memory. And once again, the day is saved thanks to a giant blue sperm monster from the sea. Yeah, I'm gonna be honest, I don't understand what happened here. I'm guessing the dragon absorbed Mia's eyes, her eye spirit, and Thieven noticed that and was hesitant, but the dragon was about to finish him off, but not before the sea monster pedophile guy from earlier grabs it by the tail and drags it to hell. But there was no water down there, so I don't know how we got there. But, it's Thieven at the end of the day. Anything's possible in the Thieven universe. Thieven looks like a fucking psychopath. All of this adventure has really taken a toll on his mental health, and he is sunburnt to shit. It looks like some serious third-degree burns, but he doesn't feel a goddamn thing. His nerve endings have been singed off. He's just happy to be imagining Mia there, looking like fucking Jack Nicholson in The Shining. Truly a heartwarming ending, and I don't understand what the fuck happened. So I guess Mia was an alien who came back and then tractor beamed Thieven to the past, back to his house, showing him what he wanted to see. So he ran to the house and he saw him. I really don't fucking know. Thieven's a little too deep for me to understand. Most humans can't really wrap their head around the robustness of Thieven's plot, metaphors, motives. It takes a lot. Scientists are still trying to decipher what exactly Thieven means and if he even came from this world in the first place. There's no telling if this is an actual human creation. Thieven may have actually just predated, you know, this species. This may have been the last remnant of whatever came before us on this planet. It's all up for debate and it's all a mystery. But one thing's for sure, Thieven will return in Avengers Endgame. At least that's what the credits to this tell me. I can't wait for Thieven's debut in the MCU, baby. Get excited. I'm just kidding. The movie's not over yet. Here's how it actually ends. Yeah, Thieven kills himself. Not exactly a happy ending here, but no one ever said the tale of Thieven was a happy story to be told. Well, that's the end of the Thieven saga. That's it. See ya.